Through blockchain, GenZ can generate financial value by getting paid with tokens for the unique lifestyle of data, biometric, environmental, genetic. This behavioral stuff of Gen Z is a very great thing, and we have a great lady here who can talk a lot about that. So ladies and gentlemen, please give her a very big welcome. She just got in. She's still got her backpack with her. Please welcome Dr. Sabine Seymour, founder and CEO of SUPA.
Good morning. All right, so imagine you're going, are we on? Yes, we're on. So imagine you are going to a party, or even better, your kids, your teenage kids are going to a party and they don't ask you for money, but they come back with money. We basically pay Gen Z for the unique lifestyle data, and that's biometric data, that's genetic disposition, that's environmental data. So what we basically do, we tokenize their body. So we make them the ability to create financial value with their biometric data. Hi, I'm Dr. Sabine Seymour. I'm a body sensorist. I'm also an extreme sports fanatic. I used to program Java and I worked for a Swiss securities company. So basically what we are doing with SUPA, imagine YouTube music for Gen Z meets a Swiss vault of biometric data. And that's basically what we do. But who is Gen Z and why are we interested in that generation? Gen Z born after 1996, about 2 billion population in about 2020, that's 40% of the actual population. What is very important is that about a third of them believe that wearable technology can actually enhance their health and or make them understand their disposition to certain diseases. The other thing that is important is they're financially conservative as a group because they have been exposed to the financial crisis. So actually have them or make them and give them the ability to make money with their data is very important. So only in the US we have 65 million. But what is important also to understand is that we have Nigeria, China, emerging countries like that being actually huge markets for Gen Z. So what is a longitudinal lifestyle data and why are we important? Why do we think it is important? It basically is biometric data. So it's physical data, movement, temperature, and so forth. It's environmental data. And that could easily be a pollen count, or that could be pollution, or it is a genetic disposition. So we basically create and use that lifestyle data in order to create value. But that is what we do with tokens. We basically use tokens, and what are tokens? So we have three different types currently that we're looking into. You probably have heard of an ICO. So basically you have an equity token. You have a share that you get from a company if you use an equity token. Security tokens, everybody has heard of Bitcoin, so that's basically a typical cryptocurrency. And the third is a utility token. If you're using frequent flyer miles, for example, you basically have the ability to generate points. Those points can then be used either for a digital asset, let's think about a video game, an avatar in a video game, or you can also use it for a pair of new sneakers. So those basically are the ability of the tokens give us, the ability to actually pay the Gen Z population for their unique lifestyle data that they can then exchange for whatever their desire is. What is very important also is to understand Gen Z is horizontally communicating with pretty much all over the world. So if you are a kid from New York, or from Lisbon, or from Zurich, or from Lagos, it doesn't matter because you actually do communicate without borders. So thus, really cryptocurrency or crypto and per se, tokenization, their actual data is something that is very, very keen, very interesting for them. It's very important to understand that Gen Z has never actually been without the internet. So imagine really having the ability to use digital currency in order to actually compensate. And thus, with tokens, what we can also ensure is data ownership. So what we do is we actually take the biometric data, the environmental data, the genetic disposition, we aggregate that data, we then contextualize it, and that data is anonymized through a blockchain, and then we sell it to stakeholders in either health, sports, beauty, fashion, anywhere you actually have the body being the centerpiece of your product offering. So if you are a brand within that space, you actually want to understand behavioral analytics. You want to understand Gen Z's disposition towards certain brands or certain products, their sports, their health, and so forth. So all that we can use in order to actually really understand that age group. So how do we actually get that data? Because that is very important for brands. How do we actually capture? So what we do is we have a mobile app. As we all know, Gen Z is using mobile as the means of communication per se. But what is very important, that mobile app is modular. So every single, what you can see here are tiles, has the ability to be sponsored by a specific brand. So you can create the body as a game controller, a VR environment, for example. Another one is a game. We work with game developers. So we're creating a game where you, again, use your biometric data. Another one could be where you have an augmented reality overlay. So every single brand is using different types of data points to actually create activations, create experiences. So the core of the actual app, however, is very important. It's messages, it's actually super snap, it is the ability to actually have a community to share the information within their peers, within this what we consider or call the super squad. And then, of course, we have also chat pods and so forth. So really making sure that we engage with that population. So the other thing is, how do we actually now get the mobile onto the hands and into the hands of the Gen Z population, in particular our app? Well, we go to music festivals, we go to sporting events, we go to installations where you can actually create activations. So imagine now you are at a music festival, and again, the music festival, the outdoor music festival industry is a $3 billion market, so it's a huge market. Now imagine now that you have a Gen Z being having the ability to almost have a disposable income of $150 billion. So you basically have a huge ability to use the power of Gen Z in order to actually capture the biometric data, capture different types of activations, and then actually go to market. So those events is you have a mobile phone. Everybody uses a mobile phone. If you have been at festivals, you see those charging stations, that is one thing. The other is cashless payment. Very, very interesting. You have in all the, or pretty much in most of the bigger festivals, you have a cashless payment system. So you couple that with tokens or with the ability to actually pay without cash. With a tokenization system, you actually have a great opportunity to use SUPA. And then, of course, you have the correlation between a digital environment and being in a physical environment as well. So those are the things that are very interesting for Gen Z. So the other thing that is interesting is, now, what if you don't only want to use your mobile phone, but you also have other types of wearables? So I, for example, wear an Apple Watch. We all, most of you might have used another type of wearable. Also, we have smart clothing and so forth. So basically, what we can use and what we do is, when we contextualize the data, we not only contextualize it and say, hey, we're creating a what we call a super kit, a kit for surfing, for snowboarding, a kit for diabetes, a kit for you name it. We also basically suggest desensitized IoT devices that you might want to disseminate throughout that event, or that you want to have create an app on top of it, like an Apple Watch. So if you do biometrics, you have basically typical fitness trackers, for movement. You might have an app already in your actual phone that tracks maybe your diabetes, maybe your nutrition levels and so forth. We can add that as well. So there are lots of different ways to actually make sense of it. And then, of course, you have also smart clothing that you know you might want to integrate. So anything that is an IoT device. And then just to sort of like capture the whole thing, what we do is we take biometric environmental genetic data. Then we actually use blockchain to anonymize the data. So we have permission controls. So we really understand and really make sure that there is a data ownership. We actually contextualize using artificial intelligence. Again, I'm very, very driven by the fact that we want to create an unbiased artificial intelligence that really integrates a lot of different factors, whether that is different cultures, but then also, you know, I'm a woman, so I'm one of the 55% or so. So really making sure that we use an unbiased AI to contextualize. And then we pay with tokens. But through all that anonymization, we actually are also GDPR compliant. So this is basically the full cycle. And I think that is very important for brands to understand the ability to use data that we use for health and for sports, and then correlate it and take it actually into understanding behavioral analytics, creating new products, really understanding trends, using trends and using statistical patterns, not just for one single person, but for the actual congregate of data, congregate of people. So what we did is we did a case study with Fila Sport. And what we did with them was we basically created a sports bra and an Apple Watch application. And we said, okay, if somebody is running for 500 miles, Fila Sport was basically shooting them a coupon or information about getting a sneaker for free or enough points to get a sneaker. So that was basically one of the examples that we were doing. So imagine now you can use just movement data. Only that, no genetic disposition, just very, very simply movement data. You can actually use it as a media company in a VR environment to as a game controller. You can use it in healthcare just to really do a real world evidence after a drug has been released or even a clinical study. You can do it as an insurance company to really take the premiums down, make sure that your population stays healthy because of the movement. And of course, as a sporting goods company, you can actually shoot more product because there is movement going on. So those are, it's really just one example in order for you to understand what the different layers of one data set could just be. And that's really just movement. So if you guys want to be involved and want to be super powered per se, what you basically do, you can get in touch with me. But what is very important is to contextualize and think about the data and what you want to create and the activations that you want to experience. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much, Ms. Seymour. Thank you very much.